Hello, and welcome back to California Geology. I am Dr. Robert Lopez, and today I'm going to talk about convergent margins. And remember, convergent margins involve compressional stress, where two forces are moving toward each other, two tectonic plates. And we'll find that there's three types of convergent margins. The first one is, we term it Japan type, which involves two oceanic plates converging, right? And we find that the older, denser tectonic plate is the one that's going to be pushed underneath or subducted, right? And we use a name for those islands that form to just to separate them from like Hawaiian type islands. These islands are called island arcs. So Japan is a good example. Java, Sumatra are another set of island arc volcanoes in the Indian Ocean. Java, Sumatra. We'll have islands, the Aleutian Islands off of Alaska are examples of a ocean-to-ocean convergence, right? Now, for the second type of convergent margin, the Andean type of margin, like the Andes Mountains, here there's an oceanic plate called the Nazca Plate, which is being subducted under South America. So there's an ocean-to-continent convergent margin. So here we see the volcanoes, rather than being islands, are going to be on continents, and we call this arc a magmatic arc, right? A magmatic arc. Now, remember the denser ocean lithosphere or tectonic plate will subduct under the less dense continental lithosphere. The last type is a Himalayan type, like the Himalayan mountains, tallest mountains on Earth, and here two continents are colliding, India up against Asia. So if we look at our seafloor map here, we can clearly see the path of India as it took through the Indian Ocean, spreading away from this mid-Indian Ocean ridge and collided with Asia to form the very high Himalayan range, right? So two continents are not going to subduct, so they're just going to go higher. Then down here, we see the Andes Mountains, and the plate here spreading from the East Pacific Rise here is called the Nazca Plate, and this Nazca Plate subducts into the Peru-Chile Trench to form the Andes Mountain volcanoes. And then in Mexico, there's the little Cocos Plate. The Cocos Plate is subducting in the Middle America Trench, and we see the Trans-Mexican Volcanic Belt, the big volcanoes in Mexico. And then in Northern California, we have the Cascadia Subduction Zone and the Cascade Range. California's Cascade volcanoes are Lassen Peak and Shasta, Mount Shasta. And the question that I have on the study guide is, what tectonic plate is subducting under California to yield these volcanoes? And here's Mount Shasta. So those two volcanoes are due to the subduction of the Gorda Plate. And the Gorda Plate is really kind of a smaller section of the Juan de Fuca Plate. So coming back over here to the document camera, we find that the Gorda Plate is the one that's subducting under California. But it's really part of this Juan de Fuca Plate here to the north, right? So we do have a convergent margin in Northern California, right? So going to our drawing, we want to make a sketch of this type of convergent margin, right? So here I've already started the sketch. And so by convention, we show these vertical lines to indicate oceanic crust, right? Oceanic crust. And then here I show the whole ocean lithosphere with a crust plus upper mantle peridotite, right? And it's going down into the subduction zone. This thing here is called the trench, right? So the trench is this deep furrow that'll parallel the chains of volcano, like we saw the Peru-Chile Trench and the Middle America Trench, or Cascadia Trench here in Northern California. And then there's a bunch of marine sediment that's going to be on the sea floor here, collected over time, and eventually that gets scraped off into this wedge of material that we call the accretionary wedge. Accretionary wedge. And so when you accrete something, that just means you paste it together. You accrete means attaching, pasting together. So these are all series of marine sediments, fragments of the ocean floor that have been scraped off, and they're caught here in this accretionary wedge. In fact, there's a special name that we use for this rock, these rocks, and we use the word mélange. Mélange. And mélange is a French word, and refers to a chaotic mixture, of rocks. In fact, the city of San Francisco is like that. There's Knob Hill, there's Telegraph Hill, there's a Twin Peaks, Sutro Hills up there, and all those are different rock types, and they're all mixed up in a ground mass of shale, right? So very unusual rock that forms in an accretionary wedge. And then as we go farther inland, we find that this downgoing subduction zone or downgoing oceanic plate is, every time it moves, this is a fault, right? So think of this fault that we have here. This is what we call a thrust fault. Thrust fault, where this ocean plate's moving down, and this really the continental plate in this case is riding over the top of that oceanic plate. So we'll call this a continental plate or continent. And so it's riding. So there's a movement. In fact, this type of movement, since it's in the vertical direction, we call this a dip slip. Dip slip. And dip is really an angle we measure from the horizon down to that surface. Down to that surface. So dip is usually measured in the vertical direction, right? Down to that surface. So we measure that angle of dip. So if there's a fault and it's moving, well, we're going to see earthquakes. So I'm going to put these stars here. These stars represent earthquakes. And one thing I want you to know or observe is that the earthquakes are getting deeper and deeper and deeper, right? So this zone of earthquakes in the subduction zone is really charting the edge of the downgoing oceanic lithosphere. And collectively, this zone is called the Benioff zone, named after a scientist who recognized that this is a trace of that subducting plate, Benioff zone. So the Benioff zone describes the zone of earthquakes in this convergent margin. And then down around about 100 kilometers depth over here, we're going to see a melting of the mantle. So about 100 kilometers. This is going to trigger magmas. They're going to come up. So these are the ascending magmas. And the reason we see the generation of magma here is because, remember this, this ocean lithosphere is said to be hydrated. And it's hydrated because it's been under the ocean, formed at mid-oceanic ridges, and that seawater eventually leaks out here, right? So we're gonna get some water mixed in here. And what water does, water lowers the melting point of the mantle. Water lowers melting point of mantle. Just in the same way when you add salt to ice, it'll now lowers the temperature. It's the same idea. And so when we do that, we make magmas. And that's why we get the ascending magmas. Eventually, in this region here, we'll talk more about this. We do igneous rocks, but we'll see magma chambers here, these reservoirs of magma, and some of these reservoirs will feed magma to the volcano, and we'll see the arc. In this case, it's a magmatic arc. Magmatic arc, right? Because it's an ocean to continent convergent setting, right? So there is a magmatic arc, the ascending magmas, and because of the water, we're seeing the melting going on there. On this map, I wanted to point out that I'm using this word arc, right? So the word arc is that the shape of the volcanoes, like the Aleutian Islands here, the arc, it's an arcuate shape. Even the Andes have this curvature, right? So that curvature is because Earth is not flat, it's a sphere, and whenever you make a crack in a sphere, the crack is not a straight line. It'll be this arcuate line, right? So anyhow, there is the magmatic arc, right? One thing that forms the magmatic arcs is this term called the batholith. And the batholith only forms in magmatic arcs because the magmatic arcs occur in continental crust, and continental crust is thick, so it can house one of these batholiths, right? Our Sierra Nevada is one of these. So the Sierra Nevada formed in a tectonic setting just like this. Now, for the ocean-to-ocean convergence. Note that we have a much thinner oceanic crust, right? There's no batholith. But the same idea holds. We have the trench, the accretionary wedge. In this case, instead of being a magmatic arc, it is an island arc, right? So like Japan, the Aleutian Islands are good examples of magmatic arcs. Examples of magmatic arcs would be the Andes and the Cascades. They're good examples right there. All right. Well, let's stop here.